Follow ye out of Galera Cardia, agus nullig honey ye of Galera. Good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the European Capital of Culture 2005. We are coming to you tonight from the North Cathedral in Cork, where we have a beautiful program of seasonal music and song lined up for you, which I know you're going to enjoy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are particularly honored and privileged this evening having in our audience Uachtaráin Éireann, Mary McAleese, and Martin. Now, for those of you watching, you'll be able to see during the programme some snatches of some of the wonderful events which happened in Cork during this very, very special year. But in the meantime, let's get on with the music. This is not really a carol, although I will bet my Christmas money that wherever there are people up and down the country joined in conviviality during this festive season, someone will raise a voice on this song. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome, please, Dennis O'Neill.
Jerusalem, Jerusalem, our father. once again the sea was changed, new earth there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on its streets, the gates were open wide.
The next one is called the Wexford Carol. It has remained a firm favourite throughout the country for as long as I can remember. And we have a very special rendition of it now by two of our foremost instrumentalists. Would you welcome, please, Catherine Leonard and Micheál O'Sullivan.
Thank you.
Now, John Montague, surely one of our foremost poets, although born in New York, he has lived here in Cork since the early 70s. His daughter Una, as no doubt you know, is a well-known actress in her own right. And she's with us here tonight to read one of her father's poems. It's called Christmas Morning. Would you welcome, please, Una Montague.
Christmas Morning by John Montague. Lights outline a hill as silently the people, like shepherd and angel on that first morning, march from Alclefin, Beltany, Raragan, under rimmed hawthorn, Gothic evergreen, grouped in the warmth and cloud of their breath, along cattle paths crusted with ice, tarred roads to this grey country chapel, where a gas lamp hisses to light the crib under the crossbeams' damp, flaked message, Gloria in excelsis.
Our thanks to Una Montague and Christmas Morning. Now, Cork, as you know, is home for some of the most leading sopranos in our country, not least that glorious voice which you've already heard, Magella Culler. She trained here in Cork and then in London, and now she sings with opera companies all over the world, from Denmark to New Zealand. She is going to do for us now Mozart's Alleluia from Exultate Jubilate. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to a man who is a living legend with 30 million albums worldwide sales to his credit. Can you imagine that? 30 million? He has endeared himself to audiences all over the world, not least at home here in Ireland. He's accompanied tonight on our show by our very own Cork-born harpist, Gene Kelly. Let us sit back and enjoy the music of James Galway.
Thank you.
No Christmas concert would be complete without a children's choir, and we have one of the best for you now, the Cork Children's Chorus, over 100 members from all over the city and county of Cork, under the direction of our hard-working musical director, John O'Brien. They've had a very busy year this year, and next year they take off for Japan to perform there. Our soloist tonight is Therese O'Sullivan, so let's welcome them on stage now, the Cork Children's Chorus. Now, anybody who knows anything about GAA matters will know that this year Cork brought home no fewer than 3 All-Ireland trophies. Lord save us how we know it. In senior hurling, in camogie and in ladies football. Now, Sean O'Tuama wrote a lovely poem about that icon of Cork hurling, Christy Ring. And we thought you'd like to hear it on this special night in a slightly different setting. It is now going to be recited for us by the 3 captains. That is Elaine Burke, who was the Camogie captain, Sean O'Gohalpine, who led our hurlers to victory, and the captain of the winning ladies' football team, Juliet Murphy.
Christy Ring, by Sean O'Tooma. He aimed at the impossible each Sunday on the pitch. Sometimes he succeeded. Down on one knee, trapped in a corner of the field, when his pre-Christian electronic eye lit up in combat. And the ball, a missile, sped from him straight above the bar. The air shook in awe. When a driving lunge brought him clear beyond the ruck of men, and the ball, propelled, self-destructed in the net, to smithereens of light, our cheering became a battle cry.
Do a ban was kind of corp, chaw vosh and a wig, but vor and pack air and fair sun, a oilica. Ni feel a lump, sir, force, Christy Ring, a oilica. Solim ear orenta, isir bunkumad, shinta, lakna honora, bruna bornia. Is ingus, macandacta, aqueduct, gadi, and la or viog, gakira. Gosalchin Gakriena Gohomosok Erokuntinos.
Sometimes I imagine him being venerated in the care of the great god Angus on a slab at Newgrange. And at each winter solstice, for just one half an hour, a ray of sunshine lighted up his countenance. But no friend of his could think of laying Christy Ring eternally to rest, locked in with ancient miracles. For all the miracles of the living flesh we saw, when his countenance lit up winter days and summer days, Sundays in and Sundays out, on the playing pitch.
Thank you.
And that was Éigin Nollag, composed by Micheál O'Sullivan, and the fireworks came from him and Catherine and Mel Mercier on Bones. A lovely piece of playing. Now, a new group on the international scene. They've had a fantastic debut year. Their debut album sold 250,000 in one single week. There was a time when they were buskers, but no longer. They are now John, Matt, Michael and Ben, known as G4. Hails from Coolay in the Cork Gaeltacht. He's brought his own distinctive voice right across the world. He was one of the original members, in fact, of Sean O'Riordan's Coolay Choir. And now as a solo artist, he's been described as having one of the most dramatic voices in contemporary music. This piece is called Míle Buíochas Leatsa. Let's enjoy the singing now of Irla O'Linard.
Míle buíochas leatsa, a your spirit nefo, dal chuan o sper hugus na verduas, dal ian ta reishin, an vuar vrirvena, le corn y fish gynt y snaf na dwan. Chwyr cnig y sleti y bart y chyli Sgwyr rhaen i yn tîl sio le ffôn yr stwyr bant yn eich li. is clant on reshin quietus crevocho vivlagach suot bofart out quet nocht nor squielish ten vach od lav jesh glegil dar dagus gu Thout retiv, vi fan ganere, go cas vor cesto vi fen nuel. Thou luis dar neluf, st vertig Mar luan regrene stu stad o guam nam na bo nefu is a bar of vitreke vi a goling dena stu bal
very much. Thank you very much indeed. A lovely performance there from Iarla O'Linard. Now, Cork, as we all know, has a wealth of writers and poets. And here this evening to tell us about one of the greatest of these is the patron of Cork 2005, President Mary McAleese.
The ancient Romans used to speak of the genius loci, the spirit of the place, and Cork has had more than its share of guardian spirits in the past. We think, I suppose, naturally of Frank O'Connor, Sean O'Fallon, for instance, but there have been others too, who became in their life and in their work something like guardian spirits of the city. Here tonight, I'm strongly reminded that Cork still has its guardians of the soul. And in choosing what to read on this wonderful occasion, I wanted to signal my own deep appreciation of the life and work of one of Cork's greatest poets. Patrick Galvin's life and imagination, well, they're woven into the fabric of this marvelous city. His wayward and unpredictable genius has thrilled, amazed, challenged us since he first began to publish back in 1959. Patrick is, as they say, of course, as Cork as you can get. And in his wonderful poems, the genius of this river city with its bells, its towers, hills, hidden lanes, finds its highest and its purest expression. And I want to read now one of Patrick's most moving poems. It's called For One Who Disappeared. And I chose it because it speaks very movingly of loss, of all those lost souls who, through death it might be, or through emigration, or just the workings of time, who cannot be in our company at this turning point of the year. It reminds us, I think, as poems should, how important, how wonderful it is to be remembered. Among the living, there are so many who feel as if they have faded from memory because of illness or shyness or poverty or loneliness. And this poem is a call to each of us to remember each other. For one who disappeared. Do you remember Christmas? Do you remember the snow, the child in the window, the unrelenting sea? Do you remember me? The snow whispers at Christmas. It lingers down night corners. It listens on the telephone. It opens doors and then closes them again. People disappear at Christmas. They become snow rivers, nameless, unborn. The snow buries them. The moon bleeds at Christmas. The child withers in white. The snow blossoms. Only the blind can see promises carved in the sun. Do you remember Christmas? Do you remember the snow, the child in the window, the unrelenting sea? Do you remember me?
The Gospel according to Luke. Now when the angels had gone from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. When they saw the child, they repeated what they had been told about him. And everyone who heard it was astonished at what the shepherds had to say. As for Mary, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was exactly as they had been told.
We've had a wonderful evening here in the North Cathedral in Cork, and we want to thank Bishop Buckley very sincerely indeed for the use of your lovely church. Thank you. Wonderful help and cooperation from so many people in putting this program together, and we are very, very appreciative of that, and thank you very much indeed. Now, wherever you may be watching this program, from everybody here in Cork, we send you our greetings for a happy and peaceful Christmas. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. Ihoa. God bless. Good night.
Hear a rumble. Get out of here now. Get out of here now.
The death toll is rising by the hour.
It's literally getting hit by a wall. It was like a truck hitting me. Bang.
More than 226,000.
It was a scene of Armageddon.
Return to Tsunami, St. Stephen's Day at 8:30 on RTE1.
Better than ever. The Great Crescent Shopping Centre Sale, Limerick. See you there.
Members of the Society of the Irish Motor Industry remind motorists not to drink and drive this holiday season. Happy Christmas. Safe driving from SIMI.
Land of Leather's biggest ever sale starts 9 a.m. St. Stephen's Day. Save 1,150 on these three-seater and two-seater sofas, only 11.99 the pair. And get this recliner free. Save €1,700 on this stylish corner unit, only 11.99, and get these six cushions free. Save €2,000 on this three-seater double recliner sofa, two-seater sofa and recliner chair, only 13.99 the lot, St. Stephen's Day only. No deposit, nothing to pay for a year, and immediate delivery on thousands of suites at a Land of Leather store near you.
It's hard finding time for the things you love. When I do, I like to make the most of it. I don't like letting myself or the team down. So it's fair to say that I don't have time for headaches. That's why I choose Panadol Actifast. I find it can get to work up to twice as fast as standard paracetamol tablets you swallow. Panadol Actifast. Twice as fast. It's my choice.
The Boyer's Winter Sale starts Tuesday, December 27th at 10 a.m.
There's more chocolate in Butler's Chocolates.
The DID Electrical Sale starts Tuesday 27th at 10 a.m. That's the DID Electrical Sale starts Tuesday 27th at 10 a.m. Now open in Drogheda and Kilkenny.
Ready to take serious action against wrinkles?
Introducing new collagen filler from L'Oréal Paris.
It's L'Oréal's new way to fight wrinkles.
It fills and smooths wrinkle furrows. The unique formula with silicon and collagen biospheres smooths the appearance of wrinkles on the surface. Instantly, wrinkle furrows appear reduced as though filled.
My wrinkles look filled, and my life is too. Get serious with your wrinkles.
New collagen filler from L'Oréal Wrinkle Decrease.
Because you're worth it.
At Frank McGowan's, we celebrate our first anniversary in our store at Airside Retail Park Swords. Absolutely everything in store is reduced. Everything from carpet and flooring, rugs, bedding and bed linen, to leather and fabric suites, dining and occasional furniture. Inspirational furniture and flooring at affordable prices. Frank McGowan. Sale now on.
Let the fun begin at Fantasia Bettystown, Ireland's premier indoor entertainment center. We have something for everyone. Just 20 minutes from Dublin, we're open all year round. For more info, visit our website, fantasia.ie.
To celebrate the Home Base sale, it's 10% day this Tuesday and Wednesday. And if you spend over €75, we'll give you 15% off the lot. Home Base.
Drink up, me hearty Joe-ho.
A network premiere. Pirates of the Caribbean, Christmas Day at 6:40 on RTE 1.
This St. Stephen's Day on RTE 1, there's a unique night of classic Elvis songs and festive fun in store. Elvis, in the form of Kevin Doyle and the Way It Was Orchestra, will perform all his favourites to a legion of fans. Christa Berg and George Murphy will be among the celebrities on the night who will lend their voices to some of the King's most memorable songs. Christmas with the King, St. Stephen's Day at 9:20 on RTE 1.
A reminder that tonight's lotto draws are on RTE 2 at 8. Now in 1, Derek Mooney may as well be Santa for all he's about to give away on a rather festive winning streak.
Show, Oliver Brady from Dublin! Morris Quirk from Cork. Rachel Moran from Dublin. Alan O'Connor from Wexford. And Maura Inslee from Kennymead. Happy Christmas, everybody! Ho, ho, ho!